Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video vertical analysis formula, watch the video till the end. And also, if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone. And today's topic is vertical analysis formula. In this topic, we are going to get a deep hands on the financial statement analysis. This is a portion of financial statement analysis. And let's start with the formula first. As you can see right in front of you that there is a formula that's given below. Vertical analysis formula, the income statement formula is the income statement, all the items divided by the sales into 100 and balance sheet items divided by assets or liabilities divided by or into 100. Let's study this in a detailed format. First of all, what is the vertical analysis formula? As simple as that. See, the vertical analysis is a kind of the financial statement analysis wherein each item in the financial statement is shown as a percentage of the base figure. So this is one of the most popular methods of financial statement used as it is simple, and it is called as the common size analysis. So here all the items in the income statement are stated as the percentage of the gross sales, and all the items in the balance sheets are stated as the percentage of the total sales, right? Total assets. And whereas opposite of the vertical analysis of the financial statement is the horizontal analysis. And it always looks at the amount of the financial statement over the horizontal or horizon of the main years. Well, the formula in the vertical analysis of the financial statement, the percentage is calculated by using the vertical analysis formula is equal to the individual item divided by base amount. Now, the vertical analysis formula for the income statement and balance sheet is given something like this. The vertical analysis, that is the income statement part, that's what I'm talking about. I'll just write IS is equal to the income statement divided by the total sales into 100. Now again, vertical analysis formula, the balance sheet portion is equal to the balance sheet item divided by the total sales, sorry, the total assets. All liabilities into 100. So to increase the effectiveness of the vertical analysis, multiple year statements or reports can be compared, and comparative analysis of the statement can be done. So these analysis makes easier to compare the financial statements of one company with another and across the companies, as one can see the relative proportion of accounts. Let's take an example over here. The example of the vertical analysis here is that the example of the vertical analysis of the financial statement, which shows the total in the amount and in percentage. Let's say the total sales is standing at 1 million and the cost of goods sold is just standing at $4 lakh. Now there is salary that has been paid to the workers, 3 lakh, and the rent of the office that has been paid is, let's say, around 30,000, and some utilities that you need, which tend amounts to 40,000, and some other expenses, $60,000. So the vertical analysis formula will be total all the individual items divided by total sales into 100. So the above vertical example, so how it will work. So just jot down, so we have all the details, I don't need to write. So the total sales, I'm just going to put some rows here. So the gross amount is going to be what? 1 million minus 4 lakh, that is 6 lakh. And then the percentage, 100%, 40% this is 60%. Then we have salary paid 3 lakh, 30, 40, 60. So let's say the total expense is going to be, how much? 4 lakh 30, right? You can just, if you want the percentage game show here, you can just start doing it. Or, if you want to calculate that way, then this is what, 33%, 4%, 6%, and this is the total expense, that is 43%. 33, 4, and 6. Let me define this in terms of percentage. Okay, so the net profit comes down to what? The gross minus total expense, that gives you your net, and your net comes down to what? 17%. So the above vertical analysis example shows that the net profit of the company, where we can see the net profit in both the amounts in percentage, in amount and percentage, where the same report can be used to compare with the some other industry. Where the income statement can be compared with the previous years and net income can be compared, where it helps to compare the understated and percentage of rising or loss or income percentage. As you can see, what we have done is the same thing here, percentage. Then for the year 2, how the data has been regarded here in terms of increase in the salary. And because of the increase in the salary, the net profit is going down. Okay, sales are remaining the same. The rest, rent is increasing, utilities is increasing, other expenses are increasing, due to which there's a sharp rise in the increase. Rest remaining the same, and total year 3 remaining the same. So in the above vertical analysis example, we can see that, the income statement, the income decreases from first year to second year, and then income increases to, again, 18%. So 17, 8, and 18%. So by using this method, it is easy to understand the net profit, as it is easy to compare between the years. In that, we can easily understand that the total expense gradually increased from 43 to 52, and the net income got reduced from first year to second, and then the third year, the COG has got decreased when compared to the previous years, and the income statement got increased. So if you want, you can calculate the vertical analysis of the balance sheet with the help of the another example. That is also possible. You can do the balance sheet analysis, which is also very important to learn. So now here, this is vertical analysis with the help of the balance sheet calculation. As you can see, cash, receivables, stock, current assets, fixed asset, and all the details are given. So this is your total assets, and then there is your total liabilities, equity, and liabilities details are given. Well, the information provided in the balance sheet provides the changes in the working capital, okay, fixed income over the period of time, whereas the altered business that requires a different amount of the ongoing fund, the same can be done like the income statement, where the previous years can be compared and can find out the change in the working capital and the fixed assets over the time. So as you can see, the data is right visible in front of you. Now, apart from that, I want to make you understand what exactly is the advantages of the vertical analysis formula. Well, it is one of the most easiest method of financial analysis. Vertical analysis of the financial statement provides a comparable percentage, which can be used to compare with the previous years. Different organization statements can be compared, and comparison can be made easy. Now, vertical analysis is also very useful to compare the financial statements with the previous years, and the statements and analysis, the profit or loss for the period. Where it is helpful, where it helps to understand the percentage share of the individual items, where it also helps in understanding the what we call as the structural composition of the various components like cost, expenses, assets, and liabilities. What exactly are the disadvantages? Well, the vertical analysis of the financial statement does not help to take the firm decision, as there is no standard percentage or ratio that is giving regarding the change in the components of the income statement or the balance sheet. Now, these accounting concepts and conventions are not followed, you know, vigilantly in the vertical analysis formula, and the liquidity of the organization, which cannot be measured easily or exactly by using such analysis. So the quality analysis is not done by using vertical analysis of the financial statement, and there is no consistency in the ratio of the elements. So based on this, let me make my final conclusion on this topic. Now, this method is one of the most easiest method of analyzing the financial statement. This method is easy to compare with the previous reports and easy to prepare, but this method is not useful to make the firm decision and measurement of the company value, which cannot be defined. Well, that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please do like, comment, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone once again for joining the session.